Welcome back to my channel, guys. Today, I am so happy to be able to review Parfums de Marly de Lina for you. So if that's something you're interested in seeing, then stay tuned. Also, if you're enjoying my content, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe as it really does help support my channel. And let's get right into it. Okay, you guys, so I'm so excited to finally be able to review this fragrance for you. I've had quite a few people ask. This is probably the second or third most common subscriber-requested perfume review. First of all, let's start with the bottle. The bottle is gorgeous. It is drop-dead gorgeous. I'll be honest, you guys, from the very first moment that I saw Delina, I wanted it just for the bottle. I didn't even care what the fragrance was like. I knew that eventually I would have this bottle on my shelf, if for no other reason than to admire the workmanship and the craftsmanship of this bottle. It is absolutely exquisite. So it's in this absolutely beautiful creamy pink color. It has the little tassels on the front, which are absolutely stunning. The lid, you guys, is like solid metal. Like, it's a very heavy duty, sturdy lid. It's not some flimsy, cheap plastic or even glass. It's like very heavy metal. It feels expensive. It also has this really cute, you can see me in there, but it also has this really cute little diamond on the top. So yes, whether or not the juice inside is any good, the bottle is gorgeous, and I think this is a must-have in any woman's perfume wardrobe simply for how beautiful the bottle is. This is the box it comes in, so I'm sure you guys have seen this before. It has the Parfums de Marly logo on the front, and it says Delina Royal Essence. Absolutely exquisite. Even the box is beautiful. You don't even want to get rid of the box. Okay, so the scent itself, you guys, is primarily a rosy, floral, bright, tart kind of a fragrance with a hint of sweetness from some vanilla. There's nutmeg in here and there's incense, but they kind of play like a background role and they don't really come out too much until the perfume has had a chance to dry down. So this opens with bergamot, rhubarb, lychee, and nutmeg. The heart is rose, peony, petalia, vanilla, and musk, and the base is cashmere, vetiver, cedar, and incense. And I'll be really honest, you guys, when I first smelt this, which was in a sample a few months ago, I was kind of underwhelmed with what it smelled like when I first smelt it because I think it was so overhyped and so talked about, and everybody just blew it up, and it seemed like it must be the greatest fragrance in the world, and everyone just had to have it. And when I got my sample in the mail, I remember thinking that it wasn't all it was cracked up to be. Like, it was beautiful, it was really, really nice, but I remember thinking it wasn't everything that everybody made it out to be. I can think of fragrances in my collection that cost a lot less than this one that I probably like more or will wear more. So I'm just being totally honest with you guys. I'm not ready to say, hey, you need to jump on the Delina bandwagon and you should go purchase it right now. But that being said, this is an absolutely beautiful fragrance. So to me, it smells very fresh, very clean, very feminine, very spring-like. It smells like springtime in a bottle, basically, but with a kind of a sexy feminine twist to it. It smells expensive. It does smell like you picked it up from a high-end boutique. So, like I said, I really wanted this fragrance just for the bottle, but the fact that I actually really enjoy the fragrance itself is just a bonus. So it just makes me so happy to finally have this in my collection. So the sillage for this is what I would say mediocre. I don't think it fills a room, but it's definitely not weak. I think that if you're wearing this, anybody who's within one or two arm's lengths of you will be able to smell this on you. So on the skin, this lasts me about 5 or 6 hours, whereas on my clothing, it lasts a lot longer, probably all day and into the evening for sure. So at least a good 10 or 12 hours, I would say, in my clothing, which is really good for me because I don't usually spray a lot of perfume on my skin. I'm the type of person who likes to be able to smell it on my clothes when I take them off at the end of the day or the next day. So on my skin, this actually turns a little bit soapy and a little bit tart, and I really get a lot of that incense and woodiness and that vetiver. I don't get a whole lot of sweetness on my skin, whereas when I spray it on clothing, I actually get a lot of that vanilla coming through, which is what I like. I really appreciate the complexity of this fragrance. Here comes the big question: is this a safe blind buy? I would say no, only for a couple of reasons. Number one, it's quite expensive, so I would never want anybody to go out and spend money on something unless they weren't fairly certain they were going to like the fragrance. So if you like rhubarb and you like fresh floral scents and you like rose and you like something with a little bit of incense and wood, you would probably really, really like this fragrance. To me, this is a must-have in women's collections. I feel like this is a very iconic fragrance for our time. It's one of the most talked about fragrances at the moment. It's one of the most beautiful bottles. The presentation is incredible. A little bit expensive, but the performance is pretty good. So honestly, I think this is a very high quality fragrance, and I would definitely suggest at least getting your hands on a sample, if not trying to get either this one or another of the Parfums de Marly in your collection. I've also smelt a Delina Exclusif dupe. I have not smelt the Delina Exclusif, but the dupe is incredible. So I think that either one of these fragrances would be really nice to have in your collection. In case you guys are wondering, the dupe that I smelled for the Delina Exclusif is this one by a company called Laird, and this is First Kiss Exclusive. This is incredible. I'm told from people who've smelt both of them that this smells 99% similar to the Delina Exclusif. However, I have to say that I've also smelt a Delina dupe, and the Delina dupe and the real Delina were a little bit different. So I think that obviously the real thing is always going to be a little bit better. I can't really tell you, I can't compare because I haven't smelled the First Kiss Exclusive, but this is an absolutely gorgeous fragrance. And I think that this would really be nice layered with Delina. I kind of just smelt them together on paper, and they smell absolutely incredible when they're layered together. Because the Delina has that rhubarb and it's very tart and very fresh. And the First Kiss Exclusive is primarily a woody, rosy, gourmand fragrance, but it also has a little bit of tartness to it because it does have that lychee in there. So the two of them mixed together are exquisite. They smell so beautiful together. Yeah, so if you want one and not the other, you could probably get away with purchasing the real Delina and then just the layered dupe, which I really do recommend. I think it's beautiful. It's one of my top favorite fragrances at the moment. So that's my take on Delina from Parfums de Marly. I hope that this review was helpful for some of you. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you have this fragrance and you have any other points to add, please feel free to write them down in the comments below. If you have any other questions, please feel free to ask. And if there's any other perfume reviews that you want to see on my channel, definitely let me know as well. I do try to get my hands on as many fragrances that you guys ask me to as possible. And yeah, that's all I have to say. I think it's a great fragrance. I'm very happy to have it, and I think it's definitely a must-have in any woman's collection. So that's it for today's video. I hope that you guys really enjoyed. Do head over and follow me on Instagram if you haven't already, because I share a lot of things on there that I don't on YouTube, and I will see you guys all next time.